Good morning. Today I'm going to show how to apply Green's theorem in Maple. Okay, what is Green's theorem? Okay, let region R be a simply connected plane region whose boundary is a simple closed piecewise smooth curve C oriented counterclockwise if fxy and gxy have continuous first partial derivative on some open set containing R, then the integral mxy dx plus nxy dy along the curve C, okay, where the direction of curve C is a closed curve and anticlockwise, then instead of you evaluate this line integral, if you have a piecewise smooth curve, for example, curve C consists of curve C1, C2, C3, C4, then you need to you need to evaluate your line integral over curve C1, C2, C3, C4. Instead of doing that, we can apply Green's theorem by evaluating the double integral, which is given by Green's theorem, which is del n del x minus del m del y, across the dA, mean over the region R, over the region R here. Okay, now let's go back to Green's theorem in Maple. Okay, for example, use Green's theorem. The line integral mxy dx plus nxy dy along the curve C oriented counterclockwise, and the curve C must be closed. C can be a piecewise smooth curve, and is equal to double integral del n del x minus del m del y dA over region R. To evaluate the line integral, in this case, the line integral m is actually x squared plus y squared. M is a coefficient for dx, and the n coefficient for dy, which is 2x, where C is the boundary of the region between upper semicircle, x squared plus y squared equal to 4, and x squared plus y squared equal to 9, oriented counterclockwise. So first of all, it's a good practice. You always restart to clear up the memory. We would like to plot the curve C1, C2 to see where is the region R here. So we call the package with plots. And then we would like to plot the circle where you have XY defined implicitly. That's why we call implicit plot. We want to plot two graphs together, so you have the square bracket x, and then power is a shift 6. So if you don't want to display it, hide x squared plus y squared equal to 4. Another one, x squared, shift 6, and then press your left arrow, plus y power 2 equal to 9. Close the square bracket. The first one is a circle with radius 2 unit. That's why I put up. Second one is a circle with radius 3 unit. That's why I put up the bigger range. X equal to negative 3 until 3. They say it's upper semicircle, that's why y, I put positive part only. And you see, they are not in the correct scaling, and if you want to change the color, let's say the first one you want red, the second one you want blue. We want in the proper scaling, because semicircle, but this look like and not the semicircle. If you want to label, the legend, let's say C, if you want subscript this one, C 1, let's say I want capital C. So the red K is a curve C1, the blue is a curve C2. Okay, now we want to evaluate, identify your M and N first. M is the coefficient for dx, which is x squared plus y squared. And then M, we find del M, del Y. M is del M, never mind. Okay, we find, identify N. N is a coefficient for dy, which is 2x. Okay, and then I will evaluate the integrand del N, del X minus del M, del Y. And let's say I put it into the F. Okay, I want del N, del X. Partial derivative, so go to the calculus template, del N del X minus, okay, I want del M del Y. Right, correct formula, del N del X minus del M del Y. So differentiate n respect to x is 2, differentiate m respect to y is 2y, so 2 minus 2y. And then the okay, that's why this line integral, okay, but the region R here, the region R is a like a donut, okay, donut, half of the donut shapes, so is k. Okay, will because involve, if it involve the circle, normally the double integral dA here will use a cylindric, not sorry, polar coordinate where the dA will change to r dr d theta, and then where the actually x, if we got variable x, we change to r cos theta, y we change to r sin theta. Hence, okay, I will substitute. Okay, y, r is the radius of the circle in, r is a, maintain r, y substitute by r sin theta. So find the theta from the Greek template. Okay, substitute, because the f, you got y, substitute y equal to r sin theta into the f. Okay, now we would like to evaluate the line integral. It's a double integral. Double integral. So the f is a f is this f, because sometimes not italic. This f. Okay, dy dx or the dA we change to where r dr d theta. Okay, and then r in this case is actually radius of the circle, this from the red color curve until the blue color curve, where this is radius r equal to 2 until r equal to 3. So r will be 2 to 3. Okay, theta, you have the okay, upper semicircle, theta is actually rotate from x, okay, positive until x negative here. So it's half cycle, theta will be pi. And you evaluate it. Okay, hold on, y. Yeah. The y still not yet. Let me restart. See what happened. Mn, the f is here. Okay, I think I have here. So okay, I substitute y equal to r sin theta into f, and then the result 2 minus 2 r sin theta put back into the function f. Just now I think I didn't put back. Okay, so now the line integral, okay, f now is y already chained to r sin theta. So the dA in okay, polar coordinate will be r dr d theta. R in this case is a donut area, r from 2 until 3, theta 0 to pi. So this is the answer. We check with the manual, the manual calculation here. 5 pi minus 776 over 3. Yeah, correct. Okay, so this is how we apply the Green's theorem in MAPPO. Straightforward, okay. Because we can plot the curve and know where's the region, and then we can easily use a partial derivative to get the function f, which is del n del x minus del m del y, then apply easily to the Green's theorem. dA in this case is you have the circular region, we use the polar coordinate where dA we chain to r dr d theta. Okay, r in this case is from 2 to 3 because it's a donut area, theta 0 to pi. Okay, with this, thank you for your attentions.